For thousands of years, peoples of the First Nations have walked on this land.
As we gather, we acknowledge that we stand on the traditional territory of the Kla'amin Nation.
May we live with peace, respect, and friendship on this land. Well, good day.
Good day. It's Lent.
I'm not even going to ask you.
In case you were wondering.
No, I'm not even going to ask you. So what's next week?
I see it right on the instructions here. It says what it is. Next Sunday is Palm Sunday.
Yes.
With communion.
And we're going to have communion next week.
Says so.
Well, thank you for paying attention. This is a test, you know.
That's right. And Lent is over when?
Yeah, when is it over?
At its end.
Yeah. I think we get into Holy Week, then Lent is over.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's right.
Okay, so what's new? Nothing?
Well, yeah, I suppose.
You don't have to copy me every
I don't know if anything particularly is new.
Well, what happened yesterday?
Harmony Vespers.
Yes.
Yes. But that's, I was thinking about that, but that's sort of, well, I guess that's that sort of new.
Yeah.
It's not happening in the future.
And who was here?
Ken. Ken Mason was here doing his, what you call the old songs.
Yeah.
Which are the songs I grew up with, so they're not really old to me.
Look, you're old. And getting older every day.
Well, so are we all. That is not unique to me. We're all of us getting older every day. Yes, that's true.
And isn't that a good thing?
It always reminds me of my daughter.
Yes.
She's in her 20s, who always talks about old movies that were made in the 1990s. So everything is relative in this world. To me, old movies are movies that were made back in the 30s and the 40s.
You weren't even around then.
That's why. That's why they're old movies, is because they were made before I was born. Just like the movies made in the 1990s were basically made, you know, basically before
recently?
She was born.
Recently?
Made before she was, yes. Recently for me. That is, I was in my 30s when I was when I was watching movies
dream
in the 1990s.
Anyway,
I like my age.
Anyway, so what's your favorite movie?
Oh, I have a number. It depends. I was thinking about this for some reason not too long ago. It depends, really, on... I mean, I enjoy a variety of different movies at different times. I really like Casablanca. That's always that's an excellent movie. But.
Casablanca.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you?
I'm very eclectic in my movies.
That's what I was saying, too. I didn't use the word eclectic, that's all. I like different movies.
Yeah. Well, I do.
Yes, so do I.
So it's hard to have a favor.
That's what I was saying, just in different words. You're just copying what I said using different words.
No, you weren't saying that.
That's exactly what I was saying.
I didn't hear you say that.
No, because you weren't even listening to what I was saying. You were too busy thinking about what you were going to be saying.
That's true. You don't have to tell everybody that.
I'm not saying you're copying me, because you would never do that. Copy, you'd have to actually pay attention to what I was saying, so I don't believe that's the slightest bit that you were copying me.
Oh, I would never copy you.
No, never. I know that.
Oh, my goodness. Life is an adventure, isn't it?
Yes.
It's a good thing.
Well, it's an adventure, yeah. May you live in interesting times.
And you do.
As the old curse goes.
Yeah, it's not a curse.
It is when you it depends. It depends on your perspective. But it's supposed to be an old curse. May you live in interesting times.
Yeah.
Interesting times also quite often being dangerous times, right? Historically speaking.
Well, you're not living in dangerous times.
No, I'm not. I'm just saying historically. It's an old saying, supposedly. So, historically, interesting times quite often meant dangerous times. Times of war and famine and disease, so interesting times.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
At least in this country, and in much of, North America and at least Western Europe, where we don't, we're not, it's very unlikely. Our negative things are not nearly as negative as the past has been and is still true in many countries today.
Okay.
Yeah. So be thankful for what you have.
That's your opinion.
Yes, that's my opinion. I'm sticking to it.
I shouldn't let you talk. No, you never stop.
No, do you let me? You tell me I have to. Mm-hmm. You encourage me. You require me to talk.
I never tell you to talk.
Yes, you do.
I just have to throw out a subject and you go on and on.
You
and
ask
on.
Me questions.
Well, yes.
And it would be impolite for me not to reply.
Mm-hmm. Right. Okay, should we go on with our service then after all
that? That's what I've been waiting for, as has everyone else, I'm sure.
Yeah. Well, you have to talk on and on and on. Okay.
I'm just sitting here.
Okay, let's get into our call to worship. Come out of the depths of the wilderness of all that has been lost. Push away the stone and wonder what glory could be.
We believe that there is more than this sorrow.
Come out into the morning light and find others waiting and hoping for love to mend hearts again.
Our souls come together to watch and wait.
Come, let us worship. And I want to thank everyone for your offerings, your gift of monies that come to the church. And there's a number of you that do help us out, and we really appreciate that. God of life, you invite us to share life. We offer these gifts of money and pray that they may bring life and hope to those who receive them. Amen.
Amen.
And let us pray. Gracious one, God of all compassion and consolation, your breath alone brings life to dry bones and weary souls. Pour out your spirit upon us, that we may face despair and death with the hope of resurrection and faith through Christ. Help us to dance with the spirit, the breath of life, which calls us out of the valley of dry bones and into the reign of God, both a present reality and the grounding of our future hope. Holy One, Christ, who revealed the way of life, inscribe your law on our hearts that in this life we may be your body. Help our hands to hold the sick and suffering. Help our feet to walk with the poor. Help our ears to listen to those who live in despair. May our eyes be affixed upon the suffering of the cross and the hope of the empty tomb, so that we may live as resurrection people. Sovereign One, in the power of the Spirit, you know our faults, and yet you promise to forgive. Keep us in your presence and give us your wisdom. Open our hearts to gladness. Call dry bones to dance and restore to us the joy of your salvation. We pray this in the name of Jesus the Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. As we continue to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
And our song is Voices United, number 352, I Danced in the Morning.
I danced in the morning when the world was begun, and I danced in the moon and the stars and the sun, and I came from heaven and I danced on the earth. At Bethlehem I had my birth. Dance then wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance, said he, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. the scribe and the Pharisee, but they would not dance and they would not follow me. I danced for the fishermen, for James and John. They came with me and the dance went on. Dance then, wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance, said he, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. I danced on the Sabbath and I cured the lame. The holy people said it was a shame. They whipped and they stripped and they hung me high and left me there on a cross to die. Dance then, wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance, said he, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. I danced on a Friday when the sky turned black. It's hard to dance with the devil on your back. They buried my body and they thought I'd gone, but I am the dance and I still go on. Dance then, wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance, said he, and I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he. They cut me down and I leap up high. I am the life that will never, never die. I'll live in you if you live in me. I am Lord of the dance, said he. Dance then, wherever you may be, I am the Lord of the dance, said he. And I'll lead you all wherever you may be, and I'll lead you all in the dance, said he.
Our contemporary reading is an excerpt from The Healer's Tree. Annie Happenstall writes, "Today we know there are still children of God, human and animal, who are enslaved by many means, trapped in demoralizing and soul-crushing circumstances. Although enslavement can be blatant and easy to identify, there can be more subtle forms, the trap by which so many of us are caught, which demand our time, our energy, our lives, for the vision and prosperity of somebody else. If we give in such a way out of love, then we are walking in the footsteps of saints. But when our labor is dragged out of us under compulsion, then we share in the exploitation of the whole of creation. Paul talks in Romans of creation groaning under bondage to death and decay. But humans add to that oppression by the heavy demands we make on the earth. Living in the light of the resurrection, our role is not to perpetuate enslavement, but to look towards and work towards true liberation, which is the blessed state of the kingdom of God, as Jesus proclaimed." And our scripture reading is from the book of Ezekiel, chapter 37, verses 1 through 14. The vision of the dry bones. God's power came on me. The Spirit of God carried me out of the city and put me down in the middle of the valley. The valley was full of dead men's bones. There were many bones lying on the ground in the valley. God made me walk all around among the bones. I saw the bones were very dry. Then God said to me, "Son of man, can these bones come to life?" I answered, "Creator, only you know the answer to that question." Then he said to me, "Speak to these bones for me. Tell them, dry bones, listen to the word of God. This is what I say to you. I will cause breath to come into you, and you will come to life. I will put sinew and muscles on you, and I will cover you with skin. Then I will put breath in you, and you will come back to life. Then you will know that I am your God." So I spoke to the bones, as God asked. I was still speaking when I heard the loud noise. The bones began to rattle, and bone joined together with bone. There before my eyes, I saw sinew and muscles begin to cover the bone. Skin began to cover them, but there was no breath in them. Then the Lord said to me, "Speak to the wind for me. Son of man, speak to the wind for me. Tell the wind that this is what God says. Wind, come from every direction and breathe air into these dead bodies. Breathe into them and they will come to life again." So I spoke to the wind as God said, and the breath came into the dead bodies. They came to life and stood up. There were many men, a very large army. Then God said to me, "Son of man, these bones are like the whole family of Israel. The people of Israel say, 'Our bones have dried up. Our hope is gone. We have been completely destroyed.' So speak to them for me. Tell them this is what the God says. My people, I will open your graves and bring you up out of them. Then I will bring you to the land of Israel. My people, I will open your graves and bring you up out of your graves. And then you will know that I am your God. I will put my spirit in you, and you will come to life again. Then I will lead you back to your own land. Then you will know who I am. You will know that I said this and that I made it happen. This is what God said." And our song is "Dem Bones, Dem Dry Bones."
This morning is called "Your Light" by Donna Ashworth. Your light does not come from your success. Your light is not ignited by perfection or achievement or body shape. Your light is not fueled by popularity or acceptance. Neither is your light at any risk of being put out when other lights around you are bright. Your light is simply made of the you-ness that makes you, you. The worries you have in the night, the music which sparks your joy, the books you had to read twice, the memories stored safely in your heart, the people you love and the people who love you. Your light is never dependent on how you look or how you perform. It's just there, and it's quite simply brilliant, and it's all yours. And it lights up every room you walk into, whether you activate it or not. What a wonderful thing. Shine bright, little fighter. This dark world needs your glow. Let us pray. When we are overwhelmed or in despair, we turn again to you, O God, for you feel our anguish and will lift us up. Breathe your spirit into us and give us new life so that we may walk in hope. Amen. Well, as our journey through Lent draws near to Easter, we hear one of the most imaginative, dramatic readings in all Scripture, Ezekiel's vision of the Valley of Dry Bones. This vision reminds every generation that God not only gives life but restores life, that death will not have the last word, even when all signs of life have been taken away. Our God is the Creator God of life, its origin and goal. The reading opens with Ezekiel, a prophet raised up by God for Israel, exiled in Babylon, being brought by the hand and Spirit of God to a valley full of dry human bones. After the prophet walks all around these bones, God asks, "Mortal, can these bones live?" Bones, dried up. This is a way of saying we have lost our confidence, our strength, our faith, our hope, our joy. Given the isolation we have come through, I expect we know what dry bones feel like by now. Those grown fragile by loneliness, by the not knowing what is next, and certainly not what is expected of us now. These bones which are fractured by grief, by faltering faith, perhaps by coming to an ever-deepening understanding of all that is broken between us, that maybe we have never fully recognized before. By our own inability to see how we are called to step out next in the promise we have been given. We know dry bones in whole new, no doubt, undesirable ways. And yes, no doubt many among us find ourselves thirsting for what we remember, for that would be much better than what we have found ourselves having to settle for these last few years. And wouldn't it be amazing if with only a breath it would all return to what we cannot help but remember? To when we hugged freely and without a moment's hesitation, when lunch with a friend, a Friday night outing to enjoy the theater was practically an everyday thing, when a trip to the grocery store, to the post office, or for a simple medical checkup didn't have us thinking twice. To those years when we made plans, not worrying about people getting too close or there being too many around us. These days are already on their way. Even though we do return, we do not return to the same as we were. For we know now what dry bones are, in a way that maybe we never did before. At least this is what it's like for me. For we will always remember this time. It was not too long ago when we could not hug frequently and freely, when we could not see the expressions on the faces of friends and strangers, when we lived in terror that a loved one would wind up in the hospital and we would not be able to be with them. When too many lived out the unspeakable heartbreak of not being able to be there for a loved one's last breath. Will we forget the life-robbing gaps this last seemingly endless time has brought to light? The discrepancies between those who could stay home and those whose work put them in harm's way day after day, month after month? Between children who had all that they needed to learn at home and those who fell ever more quickly behind? Together we are, or have been, in some ways all those dry bones, and together we will find ourselves moving forward, knowing what that was, even as life embraces us once more. It is into all of this that Ezekiel offers a vision of a collection of disconnected dry bones now standing on their feet once more. And I wonder if those bones were all the more changed for the better, knowing what they could not have known before about all that can disrupt us and about the unequaled significance of God doing what God does next. We do not yet know what that will be, what all of this will mean in our life together, or even for how we will relate to it in the years to come. The very breath of God will be the source of whatever good lies before us. Indeed, the first promise is that for all that we have been through and through all that is yet to come, God is not done yet. And God's astounding work is always to bring hope where despair seemed to have the last say, and life again where the dry bones were even long abandoned. Hope can feel impossible in a world overpowered by racism, xenophobia, terrorism, war, and death. And yet it is precisely in the face of these challenges that God invites us to read the stories of new life and new hope. How can we give in when God is so loudly proclaiming life in the midst of chaos? For many people, a sense of hopelessness is real. We can readily relate to finding a valley filled with dry bones and devoid of any sense of life. We experience collective grief at the loss of vast amounts of innocence, understanding, and camaraderie. When confronted with these realities, it is vital to explore the concept of hope. Hope that is transformative and lasting may need to come slowly. It is also far more important than getting bogged down in arguments over whether things related in Scripture actually happened or not. That is virtually never the point. The point that runs through the reading this week is about God bringing us hope when that seems gone for us. We celebrate that even in despair, even when the world seems to be plotting against God and all of us, still God will bring life. So this week, find a quiet moment, maybe light a candle, and held in this light's warmth, remember those you have loved and lost. Give thanks for their memories, that they might be a blessing to you now and always. And so be it. And our song is Voices United, number 703, In the Bulb There Is a Flower.
Seed, an apple tree.
So this week, let us pray for all of those who feel that their bones have dried up, and let us pray that they can find something in their lives, someone, some spirit that gives them life. And let us pray for them that God, they recognize that God is around them and with them always. And let us pray that God breathes that spirit inside them. We cried to God from the depths, and God heard our voice. We came with our burdens, bound by our fears. We leave this place with hope, released to serve a living God. Go in the strength of God, who shows steadfast love, in the courage of Christ, who shares our humanity, and in the companionship of the Spirit, who gives life. Amen.
Amen.
And our song is More Voices number 221. I am walking a path of peace.
I am walking a path of peace.